What's up, Nhsm? We're here, the sun is out, and we've got a big old obstacle course and a big old slide, and we're gonna do some stuff with it. We are gonna do an obstacle course challenge.
Yeah.
Silence! All right, so we're gonna be on teams, but it's not gonna be as easy as you think, because some of us are gonna be all dizzy because we're gonna spin around, and some of us are gonna have blindfolds on. And we're gonna do the team obstacle course challenge, so let's see who wins!
Yeah.
What's up, Nhsm, and welcome back to our final chapter of our current series titled Call to Community. If we haven't met yet, my name is Eric, and I wanted to start us off tonight by telling you guys about a time when I was just beginning to go to church more. I had finally gotten to a place where I was ready to help out, I wanted to contribute, and so I started asking just in different places of the church where I could help out. And through my asking, I found out that there was just so many things that I could get involved in. But me, you know, I kind of gravitated towards the technical side of things. And immediately through my asking, this one guy reached out to me and he was just super stoked, super excited that I wanted to help out. And he even gave me a list of graphics that I could potentially work on. And he gave me 2 weeks, which is plenty of time to do that kind of work, especially with what he was asking. And so I agreed to do it. And guess what, guys? I didn't do anything. And I guess I wasn't used to that kind of work, and I also didn't really trust in my skill set, and part of me didn't want to like disappoint anyone or look bad in the process, so I guess that's one of the reasons why I didn't do anything. But anyways, 2 weeks went by, and naturally this guy followed up with me at the church. He asked if I had done anything yet, and I told him no. He was totally cool with it. He's like, it's all right, man. Well, what if I put together a CD for you with everything on there? Would that help? I'm like, yes, that would totally help. Please get that for me. So he took a week to put it together and then gives it to me. And guess what I did with it? Nothing. Again. And it's embarrassing to admit. But what's great out of this whole thing is the perspective that I gained on the church, on that group of people that I didn't have before. See, after two more weeks had gone by and I still hadn't done anything, I was really expecting this guy to show up at church and just lay into me, you know, and he would have had a good reason to, like, why haven't you done anything? You know, you said you were going to do it, I gave you what you needed, blah, 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 you know, and where I thought he was going to lay into me, he didn't. And what's crazy about that, guys, is I almost didn't go to church that day in order to avoid having that confrontation or avoid having to face that. And that didn't happen. You know, I got to church early that day, about an hour early, and there he was. He was running back and forth between the stage and the sound booth. And see, the thing is, his main gig was he was on the worship team, you know, part of the band. And he was helping get the instruments set up. He was helping get the soundboard set up. And as he was doing all of that, I'm noticing a bunch of things. Right, he's got lyrics ready to go on the computer, that's ready to go. The graphics that he asked me to put together, yep, well, there was a new slideshow up on the screens, just kind of cycling through his new graphics, and I'm just like, I felt this big, you know, and I'm standing there seeing him do all these things, and I'm thinking to myself, how would he not be frustrated with me? He's doing so much, and I'm literally standing here doing nothing. So anyways, he's going back and forth between the stage, and on his way back to the stage, he sees me, and with sweat trickling down his face and with a smile on his face, he says to me two words. He says, "Hey, bro," and he kept going. Oh, you guys, this floored me. You know, this guy, he had a perspective on the church, on this group of people that I didn't have. You know, he had this sense of responsibility towards them. And I was finally, through his actions, starting to see that. There's a passage in the Bible, and it's found in the letter to the Hebrews. And it sheds a little bit of light on what was happening between this guy and me. You know, and so to give a little context, in the first half of this letter, the author really puts an emphasis on who Jesus is, puts him into perspective, how we should view him, how we should draw near to him, how when we do that, we'll get a hope that we can be sure of. And then in the back half of his letter, he shifts his language to being like, well, now that I've told you all these things, this is how you should live in light of everything that I just said. And then look at what they wrote in verses 24 and 25 of the 10th chapter. And again, this is in Hebrews. They say, "And let us consider how we may spur one another on toward love and good deeds." Verse 25, "Not giving up meeting together, as some are in the habit of doing, but encouraging one another, and all the more as you see the day approaching." So there's four parts of these two verses that I want to quickly point out. And the first is in verse 24, the words, "let us." That's together. Let us. You guys, as a community of believers, we don't operate alone. We're in this together. Think about how much stronger we are when we band together with other people towards a project or an effort. You know, everyone is uniquely talented and brings something different to the table, but together we can accomplish something that goes beyond whatever we could, anything we could ever do on our own. And how much more could we accomplish with Christ as the head and each of us doing our part in this body? You know, if you think about me in that moment, as I sat there in just complete shock of the love that this guy was showing me, of the patience that he was demonstrating, it woke me up to something greater, you guys. You know, here we have this guy doing a million things, and here I am just standing there unmotivated to contribute in any way and really feeling bad about myself. But through that, Through this guy's actions, I felt loved. I was able to see where I actually needed to help. And more importantly, I got that thing I needed, that spark, to put me in that place where I was now motivated, like truly motivated to now do my part. The second thing I want you to see is the word consider. That's intentionally thinking about something. In this case, it's thinking about how you as an individual, together with other believers, can stir others towards love and good deeds. We can be so used to thinking about ourselves and how we can benefit from our environment. But in this case, we're thinking of someone other than ourselves. And we're considering them through thought, and then we're considering them again through our efforts. You know, this guy, he knew that I had just started coming back to church. And where one would normally get frustrated with someone just with their unwillingness to help, you know, they would lose their patience with them. He showed me the complete opposite. Now, if he only thought about himself, I'm pretty sure things would have looked differently in that moment. But it was through those selfless efforts of his that I was able to see the kind of love that believers should be demonstrating to each other. And then the third thing I wanted us to look at was the words spur one another on toward love. You know, spur, a synonym of the word spur is provoke. And when we think of the word provoke, we might think of doing something negative to someone to get some sort of a reaction. But in this case, we want to provoke others in a positive way, in a way to get a positive reaction. And the reaction I'm talking about, well, it's a nudge towards love and good deeds. And this guy, he needed help. He needed a lot of help because he was doing a million things, but he decided to help me, someone who didn't even need that much help. He gave me a CD with images. You know, he would follow up with me, never losing his patience with me, to the point where he ended up just doing all the work himself. But each one of his actions stirred my heart towards the church, towards God, and drew me closer towards, again, the church and towards God, not away. Then the fourth thing I want you guys to look at is the part that says not giving up meeting. You guys, it's very difficult to encourage others towards love and good deeds when we're alone. Seriously, try it. If you're alone right now, try and encourage someone towards love while you're by yourself. Don't text. And see, and that's why the passage encourages us to keep meeting as a church. Not at the church, but as a church. As a group of believers, we demonstrate love and can encourage others through our service to them when we're together. And the result of this is that they're influenced through our own Christian walk, just as I was influenced through his walk that day. If either him or I hadn't shown up to church that day, things would have looked differently for him, for me, and I wouldn't have had that experience. You know, maybe the experience I would have had would have been one that would have kept me in that unmotivated place. But because both he and I kept going, it ended up changing my life. And as a result of that, him and I are both now joined together with the hundreds, if not millions, of other believers on a mission to encourage one another. You guys, as we close our series on the call to community, I want to encourage you guys to do four things. The first thing is to join us in this great work. Each of you have such a unique part, and we cannot do it without you. You know, if you're a current follower of Jesus, I want to remind you guys that you were saved from more than just your own salvation. Step out with us, with others, into the world, and let's spread that message of truth. But maybe you're not a follower of Christ. Maybe you're still trying to figure out this whole Jesus thing and still trying to see where you land on all that. Well, maybe the first step for you is to draw near to Jesus. I would encourage you to, as you draw near to him, to put your trust in him, because only then will you discover just how unique you are, how loved you truly are, and what great opportunities to impact others wait for you. The second thing I want to encourage you guys is to think about the situation of others so that when the appropriate time comes, you know how to respond accordingly. Don't always be thinking about yourself, think about others. The third thing, to motivate each other as you're thinking about others and you're in the presence of each other, to demonstrate love and good deeds towards each other. And then the fourth thing is to connect through the various methods available to you. Connect with that body of Christ, that those people. You know, right now that we're in quarantine, things look very different, but don't let this obstacle keep you from meeting with us. Your presence and participation affect others way more than you think it does. You know, we often think of community and how that community can benefit us. You know, what do I get out of it? But we should think of community not in terms of what I can get out of it, but what, but how we can contribute to the benefit of others. You guys, in the end, I do want to be able to stand before God and give a good account of how I lived my faith. But I'm also going to be held accountable on how I contributed to the faith of other people. And I want to have something good to say to Him. And all of this, you guys, it may seem intimidating, but with God at the head and all of us in it together, we've got all that we need. And so I just want to encourage you guys to continue pressing into those very intentional things for each other and for God. So let's take a moment and let's pray. Heavenly Father, we are grateful because of who you are, the love that you've demonstrated to us first, your sacrifice, all that to give us eternal life, to give us our salvation. But from the moment that we have our salvation, we don't walk alone. We know that you walk with us. And along with that, we get to walk along with other believers. And so thank you for that, Lord. Thank you for the fact that we get to be in this together. Thank you for this community that we have. Help us not lose sight of just the importance of sticking together, especially during times where we can be so divided. For anyone out there that who maybe hasn't put their trust in you, Lord, help them that as they draw near to you, that they feel your love, that they see you for who you are, and that through that, Lord, they can come to know your love, to accept your salvation, and to join us in this great work. So thank you again, God, for what you're doing in our church and during these times. And we love you, and we praise you, and we pray this in your name. Amen.
Yeah. Hey guys, thanks again for joining us today with our NHSM online stream. First, I just want to say to the fifth graders and now sixth graders, welcome. We're so glad you're here. And the eighth graders and now freshmen, you're closer to driving, and I know you're stoked to be in high school, and we are really glad that you're here too. Just one really big thing that I want to point your attention to, which is there's a lot happening with New Heights Student Ministries this summer. And I know camps are changing and getting shipped around, but we want to make sure that you get the details that you need. So there's going to be a link in the description that goes to our student ministry page. You can click on that and get all the information you need about camp details, when our gathering's happening again. Everything that you need to know can go there, or it'll direct you to a place where you can ask questions and get in contact with people that can answer those questions. I just want to say thanks again for joining us, and you can tune in next week as we've got another episode for you coming next Thursday.